Well, the holidays can be a wonderful time. They can also be frantic, busy, loaded with overindulgence. In fact, you know they will. It all starts this week, really. So how do you enjoy the holiday season without overdoing it and stressing out? I don't know. She knows. Our next guest, Justine Froelker of JBF Therapy and Coaching, is a licensed professional counselor. Please do not try this at home. She's a licensed professional. But all kidding aside, it can be a very depressing time for a lot of people. We talked right. about that a little earlier, yeah. the environmental mm-hmm. impact. Mm-hmm. But beyond that, the expectations are high, right. the stress levels are high. Mm-hmm. We're continuing to deal with all the problems that we deal with in our normal life right. and then adding on the holidays.
Uh-huh. Right. We overeat, we overdrink, we don't get enough sleep, we spend money we don't have. So what, and we have to see our family on top of that.
Right, right. Some yeah. of them which like, we can't whoa. Stand. And rightfully so. Let's be
I
honest.
Mean, they're family.
All right. So what are we doing wrong?
We do all of it. We overeat, we overdrink, we don't sleep enough. Like, we don't practice our everyday balance and moderation in the holidays. We overindulge, and it almost always backfires. Always.
Right.
And so, like, because we stay up too late, or we drink too much, or we spend money we don't have, and mm-hmm. that just adds to the stress, and we're not saying no to all of these invitations, and then we maybe are really rude to our loved ones, or, you know, things like that, and it just piles up.
I think we set the bar high sometimes, yeah. too, where we think this house has to be perfect for Thanksgiving. Mm-hmm. Nobody can see any fault in our right. home. There can't be any dust bunnies. There can't be any marks on the walls. Mm-hmm. There can't be any of that. Mm-hmm. And the dinner has to yep. be perfect. We put so much mm-hmm. pressure on ourselves. So what can we do to kind of turn mm-hmm. that around?
I mean, number one, what if we instead just made it about the connection part?
Right.
Like, no one really cares if there's a little dust bunny in the corner. Mm-hmm. They want to have good food, good conversation, and connect with you. Like that, I mean, what if we made it about what it's really about, quality time? I think one of the other things, too, is you don't have to accept every invitation. Mm. You can say no.
Right.
You can make time and space just for you and your family at home. And that doesn't go over very well with some people and some families. But just because you don't like it doesn't mean that that's not my boundary.
Don't we kind of start off on the wrong foot, though, because overindulgence is what Thanksgiving is all about.
I
mean, we're supposed to sit down and eat too much. We're supposed to be miserable afterwards. We're supposed to pay the price for eating too much.
What if we change the definition of it? Like, it's so miserable. Like, I mean, because there's also this, like, the scarcity mindset of, like, oh, I can't eat anything because I'm going to eat 5 meals in one sitting. What if instead I was like, okay, I'm going to have just a normal meal, but I know I'm definitely going to have more rolls and pie, so I'm going to have a healthier breakfast. Mm-hmm. Because, like, saving up is that scarcity mindset, and that's right. what gets us in trouble, because then we go way beyond our point of comfort, mm-hmm. and then that backfires.
Mm-hmm. So moderation is the key in a lot of it, and planning too.
Yeah, planning. So like, if you know you're gonna see some family that you struggle with, make sure that you don't go in hangry, right? Like, nothing good ever comes out of being hungry and tired and really stressed out. So like, take breaks before you go. Or, you know, I'll often say to my clients, like, I go to the bathroom a lot around my family because I take breaks.
You take a breath.
Like, I go to the bathroom and just
hit
breathe.
The gong a couple times.
And yeah. So, and just take breaks from the crazy.
Can I make a suggestion too? When you go over that, I mean, everybody's like, oh, I'm not going to eat much today because it's a big holiday yeah. thing. I know I'm going to eat a lot. And you walk in the door and start banging back the drinks on an right. empty stomach.
That's not good either.
Never ends well.
No.
Take my word for this. It never ends
it's terrible
well.
Terrible idea. It's a terrible
right?
idea.
Good ideas. Thank you, Justine. Have a nice
you.
Holiday, but take
thank
it easy.
Thank you. You too.
All right. We have posted a link to Justine's website and blog on kmov.com/moderation. No, slash great
we'll set up
day.
A special website.
Slash, good luck with that.
Good luck with that. Yeah, a special yeah. website.
So I'm probably not going to tell Justine that it's Monday, so I stop eating today.
No.
Just to prep
see,
for Thursday.
That's the wrong approach. You've got to keep that stomach stretched, my friend.
It's too late. I've already
that's
started.
That's the key.
This train is on the tracks. Thanks, guys, very much.